think you're going to know who it is. Patricia Routledge. A lot of people go for the Queen Mum. I'm breaking the rules. I'm not doing a role I'll never play. I'm doing a person I will never be. As much as I try, I want to be Patricia Routledge. And she recorded this song in like the 50s or 60s. So, yeah. Quite for no reason. I'm here for the season, and high as a kite, living in error with Maud at Cap Ferro, which couldn't be right. Everyone's here, frightfully gay, nobody cares what people say, though the Riviera seems really much queerer than Rome. It is night, yesterday night, I went to a marvellous party with Nunu and Nada and Nell. It was in the fresh air, and we went as we were, and we stayed as we were, which was hell. Poor Grace started dancing at midnight and didn't stop singing till four. We knew the excitement was bound to begin when Laura got blind onto Bonnie and Gin and scratched her veneer with a Cartier pin. I couldn't have liked it more. I've been to a marvellous party. I must say, the fun was intense. We all had to do what the people we knew would be doing 100 years hence. Dear Cecil arrived wearing armour, some shells and a black feather boa. Poor Millicent wore a surrealist comb made of bits of mosaic from St. Peter's in Rome. But the wind was so great that she had to go home. I couldn't have liked it more! People's behaviour away from Belgravia would make you aghast. Well, so much variety watching society scampering past. If you have any mind at all, Gibbon's divine decline and fall seems pretty flimsy, no more than a whimsy by way of contrast. On Saturday last, I went to a marvellous party. We didn't start dinner till 10. And young Bobby Carr did a stunt at the bar with a lot of extraordinary men. Dear Mother arrived with a turtle, which shattered us all to the core. The Grand Duke was dancing a foxtrot with me, when suddenly Sybil screamed fiddly-dee and whipped off his trousers and jumped into the sea. I couldn't have liked it more. I had been to a marvellous beauty. Elise made an entrance with me. Well, you'd never have guessed from a fisherman's vest that a bust had been whittled away. Poor Lulu got fried on Chianti and talked about his esprit de corps. Maurice made a couple of passes at Gus, and Freddie, who hates any kind of a fuss, did half the big apple and twisted his truss. I couldn't have liked it more! We played the most wonderful game. Maureen disappeared and came back in a beard, and we all had to guess at her name. We talked about growing old gracefully, and Elsie, who is 74, said A, it's a question of being sincere, and B, if you're supple, there's nothing to fear. Then she swung upside down from a glass chandelier. I couldn't